Finally, there's a Google AI feature that most people with Workspace accounts can use. Oh, it's about time. All right, let's jump into it and take a look. But before we do, let me tell you what this is. My name is Jordan, and I'm the host of Everyday AI. We're a daily live stream, podcast, free daily newsletter, helping everyday people learn and leverage generative AI to grow their careers, grow their companies. So please subscribe to this channel, like the video, let me know in the comment if it was helpful or what other questions you have. All right, so let's take a look at some of these new features from Google. All right, so here's the thing. These features are technically not new, but also very new. Some of these new features just came out about 2 or 3 days ago. So these different features called help you write, right? So these are supposed to be attached to your Chrome browser, and essentially in different areas online where you can write, you can use Google's new AI features. However, let me tell you this. This has been one of the most confusing things ever, because a lot of these features, these new AI features, have been available for a long time if you have a normal Gmail account, all right? However, it wasn't until last week that you could, if you had a Workspace account, you could start using some of these features, but not all of them. Again, it's confusing, it's annoying, but we finally have some basic AI features for Google Workspace. All right, so let me just give you an example of what that means. So here is what I'm talking about. So now, my company, Accelerant Agency, it's one of the different companies that I have. So this is, now we have a Gemini Enterprise, right? So right now it's just on a trial. I think we start paying for it, in a while here. It's a little expensive, if I'm being honest. It's $36. And there's technically 3 different tiers that you can get on if you have a Workspace account. So I wanted to see everything that Gemini was capable of as it starts rolling out to Google's different products, services, and apps. So we went on the Enterprise account, which is $36 a month. A little pricey, if I'm being honest, considering what you get with ChatGPT for $20 or with Copilot Pro for $20. Google's more expensive, so let's see if it's any good. But finally, it's like I've been waiting to use this anywhere. But let me just go ahead and give you an example. So finally, we got access, because we upgraded to this Enterprise level, we got access to Gemini. But it does look and it functions a little bit differently than if you have the kind of paid accounts for Gemini on a personal one. All right, so let me go ahead and show you what that looks like. And yes, it's different. Yes, it's confusing. All right, so let's go ahead and stop the screen here. Sorry, I know this is a lot of jumping around. So here we go. So here is what it looks like if you are in a personal Gmail account. So this is my personal Gmail. It is completely different. One thing you'll see is you have a toggle where you can go to Gemini, and this used to say Gemini Pro, Gemini Ultra. Now it just says Gemini and Gemini Advanced. It's extremely confusing. However, if you look at settings, you'll see that you have access to extensions if you are in a personal account. All right, so now let me get out of this one. All right, and now let's go back into the account that I was just showing you, and you'll now see that it's a little different, right? All right, let's see if we can get the right window here. That would help. All right, here we go. All right, the right window. So you'll see now it's completely different. So this is technically a Enterprise plan, right? $36 a month. The one I just showed you on my personal account, I believe that's $20 a month. So you would think you would have more options. So maybe you just get the Gemini Ultra or the Gemini Advanced, but you really don't have any clue. Google, you change things every day. It's so confusing. Anyways, even with the Enterprise account, you do not have access to extensions. Bummer. All right. I told you I'd get to it. We're finally here. Now let's jump into at least one feature that you do have. All right. Let's get it. Here we go. All right. So there it is. All right. Sorry. Here it is. Finally, in a Workspace account. All right. That's what I'm in right now. My work email, I can finally, after a year of waiting, I can use Google's AI to read and respond to emails. Finally. All right, let me show you how it works. It's pretty simple. So essentially here, I have this pulled out in a new window, so you don't have to go through all my inbox. But essentially, I have a very long email thread here, and I've dropped the ball on following up with my friends, Mitch and Cole. All right, so essentially now I have this help me write button. So if you've, like I said, if you've been using your personal Gmail account, or if you had earlier access to this, this isn't new, but for so many people with Workspace accounts, this is new. All right, and here's essentially what I'm going to do. I'm just gonna put in a little directive here or a prompt. So I'm saying recap the entirety of this conversation so all parties are on the same page. Please ensure that all of the important details of the conversation are recapped as a reminder. Include everything noteworthy that has been determined. There's been a lot of back and forth, new people added, et cetera. Mainly, I dropped the ball in following up, but need to get this project moving. All right, so now all I have to do is click create. And you'll see here now, Google, I don't even know what this is called, Google Write With Me, Google Gemini Write For Me, whatever, but it goes through and it reads this email, which is awesome because mainly there are 33 messages in this thread. And I don't want to go back and read everything and see where I dropped the ball. So I just tell Write For Me, say, hey, here's what's happened. There's been a lot of people going on back and forth in this email. I dropped the ball. We need to go through and, you know, write an email and let everyone know. All right, so now what I can do is I can just click recreate. So if I don't like the response, you can always just recreate or regenerate, which is super helpful. Also, this is good to just help me jog my memory so I can see, okay, where did I leave off? All right, so you can also, I would always suggest rating something. So, you know, giving it a thumbs up or a thumbs down. All right. This is also important to know. It says this is a creative writing aid and is not intended to be factual. Keep that in mind. However, I'm looking at the information in this email and this is in fact factual. So, you know, you can't just completely ignore, a thread of 50 emails, click this and click send. It's not there yet. I don't believe, but it's pretty good so far in my very limited testing. All right. So a couple other things that you can do is you can just click refine and you can click on formalize, elaborate, or shorten. So let's just go ahead and click formalize and it's going to go through and it's going to write this a little more formal. All right. So now I can click this. One thing that I wish is once you click formalize, you can't go back to a more casual tone, which kind of stinks. Also, you can't go back and reprompt as far as I know from here. You would actually have to reload this window in order to start over. So I can click recreate and presumably it's going to put it back in that more casual tone. All right, so now I'm going to go ahead and click elaborate. All right, so I wanted it to be a little longer. So there we go. It looks like it just added like one sentence, so it didn't look like it made it very much longer. All right, and now I can finally just click insert. And then, so it doesn't send at that point. It's important to understand that. So I still have to go in here and click send. But once I do click enter, then I can go back in and either, you know, click some of these shorten, elaborate, formalize, or help me write, and I can start over. All right, I know that was a lot, and it took me a while to get to the important part, but here's the important part. Finally, if you have a Google Workspace account, so if you're using, it used to be called G Suite, now it's called Google Workspace. So if you have a Google Workspace account and you've been waiting for all these AI features, at least some of them are here, including Help Me Write, which again, use it responsibly, make sure that you understand how you're using it. But in this case, it's like, this was a great use case. This is a long email thread of 30 things. I kind of knew what was going on, but I didn't want to take an hour plus to go back and read everything to know how should I be following up. So this is a pretty specific use case, but it should be something that is going to save you a lot of time. All right. I know this is a long one. Thank you for tuning in. Let me know if this was helpful, but make sure to go to youreverydayai.com, sign up for our free daily newsletter, and we'll see you back for another AI in 5. Thanks, y'all.